Hey, I'm Antoine Young, and I'm excited to present you our work, VidChapters, Video Chapters at Scale, done at NeurIPS. Our data, code, and models are publicly available on our webpage. Segmenting long videos into chapters enables users to quickly navigate to the information of their interest. This important topic has been understudied due to the lack of publicly released datasets. To address this issue, we present VidChapters 7 million, a large-scale dataset of user chapter videos. Our data collection pipeline is fully automatic and scalable. We start from a large pool of 92 million video candidates built on top of the YT Temporal dataset. We download their YouTube descriptions, use them to check the presence of user-written chapters, and only select the videos which have chapters. The resulting VidChapters 7 million dataset contains 800k user chapter videos, including 7 million chapters in total. On average, a video contains 8 chapters, a chapter lasts 2 minutes, and a video lasts 23 minutes. About 97% of the videos also include speech transcripts, and 93% of the videos have their chapters in English. Our dataset includes a wide variety of video categories, including vlogs, education, entertainment, music, and sports. VidChapters 7 million contains richer annotations than current datasets of narrative videos like How200M or YT Topal 1 billion, and is much larger than current dense video captioning datasets like ActiveNet Captions or Ego 40. We manually evaluated the quality of annotations on a random sample of 100 videos in VidChapters 7 million. We found that 83% of videos have chapters related to one or multiple modalities of the video, 14% of videos have chapters only referring to the structure of the video, like step 1, step 2, etc., and 3% of videos have chapters unrelated to the video content. The video chapter generation task consists of temporally segmenting the video and generating a chapter title for each segment. To further dissect the problem, we also defined two variants of this task: video chapter generation given ground truth boundaries, which requires generating a chapter title given an annotating video segment, and video chapter grounding, which requires localizing the temporal boundaries of a chapter given its annotated title. On the video chapter generation task, models trained on VidChapters 7 million outperform zero-shot baselines, demonstrating the effectiveness of training on VidChapters 7 million. In particular, PDVC has the best precision, and Vid2Sec achieves the best results in terms of overall generation and recall. For Vid2Sec, transcribed speech is the most important modality, but both speech and vision are beneficial, showing the multimodal nature of the task. Qualitative examples show that the multimodal model can effectively leverage speech cues and also generalize to videos without speech. We have similar observations on the task of video chapter generation given ground truth boundaries. On the video chapter grounding task, we also find that the model trained on VidChapters 7 million outperforms the zero-shot baselines. While Moment Editor cannot handle speech inputs, we hope that our results on other tasks showing the benefit of this modality in VidChapters 7 million will foster research in the temporal localization of language queries in untrimmed videos using vision and speech inputs. Next, we show that pre-training for video chapter generation on VidChapters 7 million greatly improves the downstream dense video captioning performance compared to training from scratch or pre-training only with speech transcripts, as done in previous work. In particular, the Vid2Sec model pre-trained on both How200M and VidChapters 7 million largely improves the state of the art on both the UCOOK 2 and VITT benchmarks. We also observed the benefits of scaling the size of the chapter dataset for the downstream dense video captioning performance. Finally, we explore applying the video chapter generation models for dense video captioning in a zero-shot setting, without fine-tuning. These models largely outperform appropriate baselines and also benefit from increasing the size of the chapter dataset. Further details and insights are provided in our paper.